Today, me and Nong-O, we are taking part of the XJX Bull Run 2019. And basically, we're just going to give all the runners a quick stretch before they go out for their run. In any combat sports, you have to do running. It's optimal for your cardio. So we do a lot of running, usually off-season. And in-season, we just do more explosive workouts.
ก็เลยมาช่วยอาเมียนคานเป็นผู้ช่วยสอนวอร์มอัพก่อนวิ่ง
Okay, the first thing we just going to do alternative high knee pull.
คนมาวิ่งกายแยะแล้วก็การวิ่งก็เป็นการวิ่งเพื่อช่วยร่างกายให้แข็งแรงผมก็ทำร่างกายผมตลอดก็วิ่งตลอดวิ่งทุกเช้าก็เป็นวิ่งทุกวันวิ่งเช้าวิ่งเย็นก็จะทำให้ร่างกายแข็งแรงแล้วก็มีสุขภาพที่ดีผมก็เป็นอีกคนหนึ่งที่ชอบวิ่งมากแล้วก็อยากจะเชิญชวนทุกคนเอามาวิ่งกันเยอะๆนะครับ
อันนี้ผมก็ได้มาแข่งกับพี่ก็ผมเคยขับบิ๊กไบค์มาก่อนแข่งบิ๊กไบค์มาก่อนแต่วันนี้ได้มาแข่งโกคาร์ทก็ซึ่งมี4ล้อก็ต้องลองครับว่าจะแพ้หรือชนะก็ต้องลองครับวันนี้ครับครับก็วันนี้ก็รู้สึกเป็นครั้งแรกนะครับที่ได้มาขับรถโกคาร์ทก็รู้สึกว่าสนุกครับแตกจังจากการขับบิ๊กไบค์เลยนะครับก็วันนี้ก็รู้สึกว่าโอเคครับเป็นครั้งแรกของผมเหมือนกันครับที่ได้มาขับโกคาร์ทในวันนี้ครับขอบครับรู้สึกว่าบิ๊กไบค์ก็2ล้อก็จะทำความเร็วได้เยอะกว่าก็จะรู้สึกผ่อนคลายเป็นอีกกีฬาหนึ่งและกิจกรรมหนึ่งจากต่างจากที่เราซ้อมมวยเสร็จปุ๊บเรามาขับโกคาร์ทก็รู้สึกว่าโอเคครับก็รู้สึกผ่อนคลายขึ้นครับสนุกดีครับ
They've turned out in their thousands upon thousands for one championship, Heroes of Honor, and for the launch of one Super Series. We've already seen Cosmo Alessandre with the contender for the Go Daddy knockout of the night. Will we see one here? Two stadium champions, Rajdamoon and Lumpini, two multiple world champions.Nong-O Gaiyanghadao has Pinker in high regard, but says Pinker's kicks do not compare to his. That's the weaker part of Pinker's game. He predicts he'll knock out Pinker with his hands. Fabio Pinker, who described Nong-O as a flawless Muay Thai combatant.
Michael, if you look at their stances, you can see how light on the lead foot Pinker is and how balanced Nong-O is. What do you make of that?
Pinker's going to keep very light on that lead foot to enable him to raise the shin and be able to check the kicks coming in from Nong-O. Oh, beautiful sweep there from Nong-O. That's Muay Thai 101.
See, but he fakes the kick, and as he was trying to check it, he was able to come under and cut that the support leg out.
Left hook, hard right, roundhouse from Nong-O. He is launching the heavy artillery early here.
He's got the hand up, but that kick still gets through.
These are only 3x3-minute rounds. The action is non-stop from the get-go. There can't be any feeling out process. It's straight to the action. And certainly we're seeing that here from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao and Fabio Pinker. Catch and counter, nicely done from Pinker. They clinch up.Nong-O turns him around the corner, puts on the knee guard, and referee Onari breaks them.
Go!
Scintillating first round, or according to the shorts of Pinker, a wicked first round so far. Oh, crossing elbow there from Pinker. Cracking roundhouse kick, tucks it under the armpit, and Pinker goes with an elbow, then an outside leg kick.
Michael, you gotta wonder how much ring rust is gonna take into play.Nong-O hasn't been in the ring since April of 2015.
but this is a guy Mitch has been competing since he was about 5 years old. 255 wins, he's seen it all, and he stays in condition, training out of Evolve MMA in Singapore.
Sweep out the support leg, but Nong-O just had such a strong base. He was able to take the leg kick and answer right back and sweep Pink off his feet.
Pink, nice forearm guard against the high round kick. Elbows coming into play for Nong-O. Clinching, grappling, dead center of the ring. Both men trade knees, trying to stay busy, trying to score points. And referee Onari breaks them.
Go!
End of the first round, we are seeing some succulent Muay Thai. It's all part of the One Super Series. It's launching tonight in Manila.
Good eyes by Pinka there to avoid the high roundhouse kick. Answer back with a leg kick of his own as he was on the way down. But there was that beautiful cut kick from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao as he was able to kick, catch the leg, sweep out the support leg and dump Pinka down, which does score in the minds of the judges as dominance.
More so though, when you are dumped by your opponent, it does psychological damage because you've got to pick yourself up off the canvas and no athlete wants to do that.
And when you pick yourself up, it takes energy too. How many times did he get dumped there?
Second round set for three. A very good opening round from both men, particularly from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao. See the project armbands around the biceps of Nong-O Gaiyanghadao. All part of the uniform of the Muay Thai combatants, along with the Mongkon, of course, worn around the head but taken off before the contest. On the front foot early, wanted to go with the hook, clinches up now with Nong-O, looks to throw the knees off the left, gets them off to the rib cage, switches to the right knee.
Stop.
And referee Onari breaks them.
Go.
Gloves turned out in that point eye stance from Nong-O to catch the roundhouse kicks, to catch any elbows coming in. Different to a boxing guard in court where the arms aren't turned out towards your opponent. The boxing guard, more which Pinker is using at the moment, the forearms face each other. Double roundhouse kick from Nong-O. Inside leg kick, hoping to hit that femoral profunda. Pinch again, both men trading knees, putting down the points. Now under this Muay Thai rule set in One Super Series, when you're in the clinch, the knees must be continuously used or the referee will break. It's all about keeping the action flowing. Only 3x3 minute rounds. Three judges ringside scoring on a 10-point must system, which means the winner of the round gets 10-9. If you score a knockdown in the round, it'll be a 10-8 round two.
Pinka's answering back. He's not just taking a shot and then accepting it. He's coming right back with shots of his own. I like how he puts the punches together and is attacking at different angles. Going low, going high, mixing things up on Nong-O.
Roundhouse kick from Nong-O, doubles up on him. Pinka tries to counter. Knee guard from Nong-O. Pinka looking to dump him here.
Oh, look at that defense.
Beautiful defense. The knee guard across the waist of Fabio Pinka.
And he uses the hand as well. So he's not just defending with the leg, but he's also blocking the support leg of Pinka with his arm.
A fake there from Nong-O, goes high on the inside thigh. Pinka look to return the favor. Roundhouse kick from Nong-O. Pinka's left hand falls short. Beautiful punching combination from Fabio Pinka. Stinging right hand from Nong-O getting cut down.
Heard that.
And a cheap kick. This is just exquisite striking at the highest level. This is what One Super Series is all about. We are showcasing the greatest martial arts strikers on the planet from all striking styles. Muay Thai, kickboxing, lethwei, silat, karate, kung fu, taekwondo. They are all invited to compete in One Super Series. Beautiful right hand to round kick there from Nong-O.
The way Nong-O changes stances as he's coming in with punches, it's very confusing for Pinka. He has a hard time adjusting what he's doing because his feet shuffle so quickly, and then he'll throw in a punch or a kick. Look at that switch kick. Boom, goes up top, just barely touches the head, a little bit more hip, and he could have slapped Pinka. But look at these kicks just thundering on the arms, and that's going to pay dividends later as this match wears on, absorbing the power to the arms to try to get Pinka to drop the arms and go headhunting later. But good round from both these guys. At this point, Michael, Muay Thai scoring now. Who do you give it to?
I've got Nong-O Gaiyanghadao ahead at this stage after two rounds. I feel he's just been more effective in the clinch. I think he's been more effective from range as well. But certainly Fabio Pinka not out of this one. Pinka able to turn it around on a dime. And in front of a sellout crowd inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Third and final round. A Muay Thai bout. Muay Thai, at least 2,000 years old martial art. You're seeing it at its modern day best right here. There's the roundhouse from Nong-O again. Pinka rallies back with his own. This is more like it from the Frenchman, Fabio Pinka. You can see that Pinka's turned up the intensity now. Cracking roundhouse kick. Nong-O's landed at the entire contest to that right rib cage of the Frenchman. And referee Onari breaks them. Pinka tucking the chin, looking through his brow. Can he find career win number 100? Or will it be career win 256 for Nong-O Gaiyanghadao? An inside kick from the tie. Winds up that roundhouse off the left leg again. Catches and ducks Pinka.
Beautifully done. Nong-O is just putting on a clinic at this point. He pretty much knows exactly what Pinka's gonna do, and he has an answer for every single one. You can see the way he frames off there, shields him, keeps him away, so that prevents Pinka from launching the knees at him by controlling his hips with his foot like that.
Nong-O evades the roundhouse kick, comes forward with a roundhouse of his own. That left leg roundhouse kick of Nong-O has been incredible. There's one off the right leg, just shaves the beard of Fabio Pinka. Pinka goes downstairs. Lead right hand there out of orthodox stance from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao. Pinka's got to close off the tie's movement. Nong-O again tucks that left leg under the right arm of Pinka. It's been a painted target all night for the tie. Body clinch, one way to close down the knees of Pinka. Can he dump him from here?
Pinka trying with the redirect, but Nong-O's got such a wide base, and he's got the two underhooks. It's gonna make him hard to spin like that.
That was very good refereeing from Onari to let them try and use the clinch, not to break them up too quickly.
If they're active, it's okay. They have 3 seconds of inactivity before the referee will come in there and separate the two.
Pinka edges forward again, good inside thigh kick, and then a gut-munching knee from the Frenchman. Two-punch combination from Pinka. Jab two again from Fabio Pinka. Nong-O ties him up, they tango now. Back against the ropes, and Pinka throws a knee, and referee Onari breaks it. We're ticking down to the final stages of what's been a thrilling Muay Thai bout. Pinka goes with the right hand, throws the knees to the waist. This has been a much better round for Fabio Pinka.
Yeah, the second half of this round, Pinka has definitely been putting on Nong-O. I'd like to see another two more rounds of this, Michael.
And there it is. Fantastic sportsmanship between two phenomenal martial artists. The living legend, Nong-O Gaiyanghadao, confident of victory.
Oh, beautiful. Look at the way he swiveled his hips to avoid the push kick. Beautifully done there by Nong-O. Catches the kick, holds it, and sweeps Pinka down. Just a brilliant Muay Thai clinic put on by Nong-O. But, I mean, the student was becoming the teacher as Pinka definitely worked his way back into this match in the last minute of that round, Michael. That was a good showing.
wherever you're watching in 136 countries around the world, potentially over 1.7 billion. How do you score it? Do you have it for Fabio Pinca, or do you have it for Nong-O Gaiyanghadao? It was another brilliant bout on the newly launched One Super Series, a celebration of martial arts striking. Let's go now to Dominic Lau to find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Nong-O Gaiyanghadao.
A sellout crowd inside the mighty Impact Arena in Bangkok, Thailand. It's One Super Series Muay Thai match. Nong-O in black, Mehdi Zatut in green. Inside leg early from Nong-O. Nong-O, the sweeps, the body shots, the entire package. Zatut, big time liver hitter. Can he find it? Can he dip down at the left? Nice evasion. He leaned back like Fat Joe out of the way of the roundhouse.
Yeah, that was a scary roundhouse. That came at blistering speed. And Zatut saw it coming. Lean back. Didn't evade that shot there, though.
Triple roundhouse kick there and a crossing elbow on the inside from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao. Referee Onari breaks it. Now, under our Muay Thai rule set, you can clinch up, but you've got to keep throwing the knees. You've got to keep active with the knees in the clinch, or the referee will break. Fakes there from Nong-O. In orthodox stance at the moment, both men. Nong-O switching, shuffling. Catch and done. Beautifully done there from Mehdi Zatut. Now booing Mehdi Zatut. Giving a portion there for referee Onari.
It looked like a perfect legal sweep, but I think Onari cut the back of the leg, so you're not able to cut that leg.
Rich.
After he swept him, he threw a kick when he was falling. He almost kicked him when he was down.
It's usually legal, though, in Muay Thai, to kick a guy on the way down. It's fine as long as you don't kick him when he's down.
I think his hand was already planted on the ground, and that's why.
So already down, that is an illegal technique. Good pick up there from Rich Franklin. And he's into it, backing up here. Got to be careful. Doesn't want his back against the ropes. Nong-O will love to grapple up with him, try and work the knees and elbows. A few trips back to center ring. Nong-O look for an elbow over the top. Roundhouse gets a few catches. Now, as Onari is cautioning him, you can catch, but if you're not going to strike when you catch the leg, you need to release it. You can't hang on to it. So to it. Just leans up the way, not absorbing the full power of the right hand. There's a left hand from Zatut, and here he comes Nong-O! And Zatut backs him off with the left! Nong-O, his fingers extended here in those four rounds glass, winds up a roundhouse kick with power. Zatut returns the favor. The crowd roars. Nong-O went for the meet and greet with the knee. Jab two, fires a knee, tried to dump him. Here's Nong-O! Another knee there. The tie break, final second of the first round. It's been a thriller. This crowd is electrified for Nong-O Gaiyanghadao. And there it is. Lots of luminaries here ringside. There's Yotsen Clive Fairtex, and there's the world champion, Chok Chin Nan. So many stars are out in force for the hottest ticket in Thailand tonight. It's One Championship Kingdom of Heroes.
Jong Jin Na getting ready to put on a show in November against Angela Lee. But right now, the show is all about Nong-O Gaiyanghadao. There's a big right hand landed by Nong-O, framing off the face and lands another one. Very aggressive start to round one for Nong-O. Rich, how'd you see the first round?
I'll tell you, Zatoot had that nice slip at the beginning off the kick and then came back with a really good combination 1-2. But after that, Nong-O was like, I'm having no more of this. He threw that triple kick, and from there, he just completely took the offensive. And you saw the replays there with the hands on the inside. If he wasn't landing kicks from the outside, he was landing combinations with the hands on the inside. He completely stole that round in my mind. I have him up 1-0.
What a sight it is here in Bangkok. Absolute sellout. We're told there's quite an audience outside the arena as well. We are sold out inside the Impact Arena. Here we go, second round of Muay Thai action between Nong-O Gaiyanghadao and Mehdi Zatoot. As Rich said, Mehdi started well, but then Nong-O seemed to up the tempo and start controlling. Let's see if he works those roundhouse kicks again. He does to the inside thigh. Tries to sweep out the back leg there, Mehdi Zatoot. As a 9-year-old, born to a family of farmers. Competitor Lumpini is a 15-year-old.
And those roundhouse kicks are starting to break down the body of Zatoot. You can see the welt starting to build up on the side of Zatoot's body. Nong-O marches forward with a straight 1-2.
Oh, it's the big elbow! Smack bang on the kisser there from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao. Zatoot's got to keep moving here. And then the body. Nong-O switches. Elbows of both arms, spreading them through, and Mehdi Zatoot getting caught. This is Muay Thai 101 from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao.
You can see Mehdi Zatoot starting to back up. He's getting a little weary of the power that Nong-O is starting to throw. It's that change in stance. It's very confusing to see the way that he's switching stances and the way he's throwing these shots.
Controlling the entire pace of the fight. And so that obviously that round goes to him, but that replay tells you how he's winning that round.
This sellout crowd is anticipating a knockout here in the third round. A knockdown in the second. the big tough thumping elbows from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao. He comes forward again, this very scary customer. It's a one super series Muay Thai clash. So took fakes as in southpaw stance, the Frenchman orthodox for the time. So took circling into the power side of Nong-O. There's that roundhouse kick off the rock. Crowd. That's like being in a room full of lions. On the outside, he's got to do something. He's just surviving at the moment. There's no offense from the Frenchman.
But Nong-O is letting him survive. He's letting Marizato walk around, catch his breath.
Nong-O systematically, methodically breaking Marizato down. There's the knee, tries to fold him in half like origami. And referee Onari breaks them.
You can't count Diamond Heart out. He has no quit in him. He's going to go in there from bell to bell and give everything that he's got. And Nong-O is just waiting for that perfect moment to unleash that bomb. Look at him, calling him to the center, saying, let's go. But Sato wants to survive. He doesn't want to engage. I don't blame him.
Nong-O pulling Sato forward. Will it be an elbow coming in now? It's the roundhouse, kicks off the left leg, there's the right hand. The heat-seeking missile from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao.
The aggression has seemed to have left Nong-O. He's not really charging forward. He's not, you know, initiating the exchanges. I think he's going to let, I mean, he's not turned off the hook here.
The crowd points a go-getting walk out of the night. There's an air down, goes a hook. Is Onari going to put a count on? No, not on that occasion. Have a good look into the eyes. 20 seconds remains now. Nong-O on the front foot again. Throws the kicks. The Thai veteran, unable to finish Marizato, but was able to punish him from the top of his head to the tips of his toes. What a performance from Nong-O Gaiyanghadao.
I think something's on Rich Friend's mind. Pass the mic.
I'll tell you what, I got the feeling like I was at Lumpini watching one of the matches in the fifth round when you know that you have the other guy beaten and you're just showing respect. Because Nong-O didn't he didn't throw very many headshots in that last round. I honestly believe that he knew that this wasn't just an imminent victory for him, but the possibility that he could really hurt somebody.
And so, I think you hit the nail on the head there, Mitch. If you know the sport here in Thailand, you know at the stadiums, Lumpini, Rajkumar, Channel 7, wherever it is, if they know they're that far ahead on the judges' scorecards and they're easily beating the man, they will not go out there intentionally to finish him or punish him or hurt him and affect his future earnings.
Yeah, it's a matter of respect, and it's so contrary to the Western mindset. And I remember the first time I was at Lumpini and I saw that, I couldn't believe what I was watching.
And it's why you didn't hear the crowd here boo. Yeah. But no, they appreciated it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.